Monday nights. Tonight we reviewed our basic footwork, so going over the follow-up footwork, starting with just our slow steps. We've got a slow to the right, a slow to the left, and the rock step back onto the right, forward with the left. Leaders?
Kind of the opposite. Start with the left, go to the right, and then rock step back to the left.
Awesome. So putting that with a partner, remember we're bending at the big knuckle. Leaders, you're facing the fingertips towards each other. Follow us, fingertips towards the floor. Connecting, relaxing our biceps, and we can do our basic footwork together. Slow, slow, rock, step. The first move we did tonight is a belt turn, and it looks like this. And belt, turn, and rock, step. So going through the belt turn, leaders, this is a turn for you. So what you're going to do is you're going to be releasing leader's right arm to the follow's left. From that rock step, leaders, you're going to take your first slow step forward onto the left. Follow's, we're taking a slow step forward onto the right. At the same time, you're going to be taking your left arm and guiding your follow to place our hand right on your waist or around your hip level. From there, we are going to be finishing the turn. Leaders, you're going to rotate over your left shoulder. Follows, we're turning to face our lead. Leaders, you're going to catch your follow's arm as she comes through, and then we're ready to rock step at the end of the turn. So leaders, you've got two slow steps to go through the turn. And again, it looks like this. Slow, slow, rock step. Follows, when he places our hand on the waist, we want to make sure that we keep it there and don't just release, because it's there so that when he completes the turn, he knows right where our hand is so he can easily catch it. At the end of the belt turn, you might notice that your hands are opposite. Leaders on top, follows are on bottom. If that happens, you can just really quickly, during your next basic, release the hands and reconnect. Or you can lead our next move, which was the inside-outside, and it looks like this. Inside-outside, and rock, step. So the inside-outside is a turn for both the leaders and the follows. We've got a follows inside turn first, and then a leaders outside turn second. All of this takes place in 1-6 count basic. So the first step from our rock step, leaders, that arm is coming up. You're going to lead the inside turn. So follow us, we're going underneath that arm. Then the second half, for our second slow step, leaders, you're going to be going outside underneath your arm to turn and face your follow. Then we're ready to rock step. It's really important to make sure that you break this down into two separate turns as opposed to one, because if you try to do it one at a time, both together, you'll get really caught up in each other's arms and it'll be quite difficult. We put a sequence together where we did a basic belt turn and then we went right into the inside-outside turn. So that looks like this. Basic, into the belt turn, and then right into our inside-outside. Inside-outside, rock, step. Making sure as we go through all these turns that we're taking really, really small steps. Cool. After that, we talked about closed position. So leaders, bringing your follows into closed position is going to take place at the end of that rock step. Rock, pull into closed, right? And from here, you have the option to keep your hands in that neutral position down here or bring it up in more of the ballroom handhold. To get out of closed position into open position, leaders, you're going to bring your and first slow out on the second slow, releasing that arm, and then rock step. So again, from here, we'll try it from closed position. From a basic, Todd's going to bring it in, release the arm out, and then drop, step. Lastly, we did a dip. So from closed position, our side lunge dip. Leaders, from a rock step, you're going to be taking a step out into your left as you're twisting the upper body and then guiding your follows right arm up and over the neck, and then dipping down into the side. Follows, we want to make sure that we've got our weight underneath supported by our right leg, as well as using our arm to hold on. And leaders, you can go as far or as shallow or as deep into the dip as feels comfortable, making sure that you're bracing with your hands around your follow's back and lunging with the left knee, not with your back. Did I miss anything?
Nope, that's it.
Whew. That's it. Good job.
Thank you.